Widdershins.
We're not supposed to say... Oh, I guess we gotta say Widdershins now.
Widdershins.
There's a river flowing near me. And I've watched that river change and grow. For 800 years I have lived here, through the wind, the fire, and the snow. I see salmon return every summer, and I watch young owls learn to fly. I have felt the claws of the grizzly, and I have heard the lone wolf's cry. I have seen great glaciers melting, and I've met lightning. But now I hear bulldozers coming, and I know that I am soon to die. And who will hold that river shore? And who will take refuge in my shadow when my shadow
Secrets become your world anytime, anywhere. Sticks
Misfits on Wittershins Radio.
Wittershins
Radio for your spiritual side. A twisted approach to the left-hand path. And let's see, we heard Dana Lyons opened up the set. And then Casey Neal, two men that I have shared the stage with countless times in one of my other lives that I've had in this incarnation. And then the Misfits. You know, I never shared a stage with the Misfits, but I'm old enough to have seen the original lineup.
Well, this is a new phase in your life.
Well,
that other stuff was pre-Marta, and now post-Marta, you're going to share a stage with the Misfits.
Okay, well,
you're on to bigger and better things.
Well, the thing I said, I'm old enough to have seen the original lineup. Misfits, you know, and TSA, you know, those spooky kind of punk bands, you know?
Like the Damned?
Yeah, like the Damned. It wasn't goth yet. It was OG. It was original goth. It was pre-goth. It was like death rock, and the Damned was like death rock and glam rock. And they had all these other categories before it ever became like goth.
So it was like OG, like original gangsta?
Yeah, like original goth.
Okay.
I was OG. Yeah, I was goth before there was a goth, yo.
I was the other OG.
The eyeliner. Yeah, the eyeliner. Black clothes.
Guy-liner.
Yeah, man. Guyliner.
That's hot.
You are listening to Wittershins. Twisted Approach to the Left-Hand Path. I already said all that crap.
Yeah.
So we're, where the fuck are we? June 26th?
It's like almost... over.
Well, yeah, but it's June 26th,
something
right?
Like that.
Is that it? I think it's June 26th. What the fuck? Look on the goddamn screen and you'll see what the date of the...
I think you're right.
Coming to you.
26th.
From Wittershins Tower. The 26th, yes. My dear departed mother's birthday.
Yes.
I know. I wasn't going to talk about that. It's too sappy. I'm talking the male mysteries and stuff tonight. Okay, I guess we can be sappy.
Yeah.
Is that part of our mysteries? You don't know.
I don't know.
All right.
I don't know what your mysteries are.
So, I found myself in this discussion with my wife, Marta, of late. And I have lain bare several of the core male mysteries. And she was not too shocked. It takes a lot to shock a chick like Marta, you know. She's seen some things, you know. Been around, seen some things. She's nodding.
Done some things. Yeah.
So, not shocked. But I have made this statement several times on my YouTube channel. I have never done a take two. And I haven't. I shoot. I turn the camera on. I roll. I have never done a take two. I have never stopped the camera and reshot anything that I've ever published on YouTube, on Gumroad, anywhere. I roll with it. I roll with it. Except...
You did a take two with wives.
Yeah. And I prefaced it with on my YouTube channel and my Gumroad channel. Okay, are you listening?
No.
Well, don't argue if you're not listening. So,
I'm just looking at your pretty mouth.
Except one time. One time I tried to shoot a video demystifying the male mysteries. And I tried to do it with my five-year-old son. No, God, maybe he was four. We're still at the Sacred Grove on Soquel.
Oh.
It was probably like four.
Three.
Yeah. And you know those Corels. They're fucking hams, man. Stick a camera in their face, stick them on a stage. You can't get them off unless you got one of those old-fashioned hooky things. And my son's no exception. I shot take two, take three, up to take like seven, and abandoned it never published. I hope I saved my outtakes. I can have a bloopers reel. That would be my only bloopers reel, is the one time I tried to talk about the male mysteries.
And he didn't like
with
you?
My... No, he was too much... As soon as he saw himself on the fucking camera, uh-huh. He just was a ham, and he made faces, and made noises.
That's my boy.
That's your
boy.
Exactly. So, didn't get that, but it would be a good outtake, because, you know, male mysteries, father, kids sitting on my lap, you know, that could work. It could work that thing. So, I never shot that again. I never completed the shot. And that is the only time ever. I start to teach a thing. I maybe have like one or two, you know, three-word sentences written down on a paper at the most. And I just fucking teach some witchcraft. That's just how I roll. And not too dissimilar to this show. Never anything on paper. Never much of a plan. But I'm going to my Facebook right now while I'm talking to you. There was a thing that predicated me deciding to go there. And I already got questioned, not really given shit, but you know, there was a few people, men, wondering what the fuck I'm doing. You can't talk about the male mysteries. I'm going to get kicked out of the club, honey. They're going to take my penis from me.
I'll have you in my club.
Yeah, but they're going to take my penis.
Oh, I don't want you there.
All right, let's see. Wait. Okay. No, Knox, not that one. I'm trying to scroll back.
What are you doing?
I'm scrolling on my page for the thing that led to all of this.
The male mysteries?
Just listen, woman.
What?
I'm going to tell you about the male mysteries.
Okay. I already know about the male mysteries.
But you don't know how I got to where we're here.
Okay.
So part of the bardic arts is the path to the story.
Oh.
I don't expect you to understand. Any of you. So I don't know where this first came from, what man out there started this, or if it was a man, but I got tagged with like 40 other people to post this thing on my wall, and I never do that. I never, you know, post this thing to your status. I never fucking do that for any fucking reason. This one got me. Maybe, you know, maybe it's my Cancerian side. Maybe, you know, my heart got touched by such a gesture from one of my brothers out there. I don't know who. But here's how the thread goes that's being shared by men on Facebook. And who knows where else? I don't know. I'm just on Facebook. I'm generally not one for cyber spells, but I'm all for celebrating awesome men, uplifting each other, giving masculinity a good detox. So I'll play along. Cyber spell to chip off the iceberg that is toxic masculinity. Be a man. Phallus optional. Build. Don't tear down other men. I felt the pain of being torn down, and I've decided I will be deliberate about building others up. If I didn't tag you, please don't be offended. I tried to pick people I thought would do this challenge. All too often, we men find it easier to criticize each other instead of building each other up. With all the negativity going around, let's do something positive. Upload one picture of yourself, only you, and tag as many brothers to do the same. Let's build ourselves up instead of tearing ourselves down. You know, that's the first time I've ever seen a man... Wait. Who's on my personal hotspot? I turned off my personal hotspot. Is that you?
Me?
Is that the kid? All right, I turned it off again.
You were
on my hotspot, man. All right, I was sharing my internet with somebody for a minute there. I did away with it. I've never seen anybody do that kind of thing. A man do that kind of thing. Because, I don't know, it's not manly somehow. You know, it shows a sensitive side, which, you know, men amongst men, you can't do that. or allegedly, you can't do that. You can't show a brotherly side out in public. That's the way we're raised. That's maybe some of the male mysteries we'll be going into, but that's the thing that led to it. And I don't want to give it all up right away. I got a... You know what? This one's perfect. We played this on the Beltane episode, but it's the Maypole song from The Wicker Man. You know, where the boys are dancing around God's penis on Wittershins.
There grew a tree, and a fine, fine tree was he.
And on that tree there was a limb, and on that limb there was a branch, and on that branch there was a nest, and in that nest there was an egg, in that egg there was a bird, from that bird a feather came, and all that feather was a bed. And on that bed there was a girl, and on that girl there was a man, from that man there was a seed, from that seed there was a boy, from that boy there was a man, from that man there was a grain, from that grain there grew a tree. And on that tree there was a limb, and on that limb there was a branch, on that branch there was a nest, and in that nest there was an egg, and in that egg there was a bird, from that bird a feather came, and all that feather was a bed. And on that bed there was a girl, and on that girl there was a man, on that man there was a seed, on that seed there was a boy, on that boy there was a man, on that man there was a grain, from that grain there grew a tree. And on that tree there was a limb, and on that limb there was a branch, and on that branch there was a nest, and in that nest there was an egg, and in that
Madonna. That's all he wanted, that was all, to one day go down on Madonna. And when my friend was 34, he got his wish in Rome one night. He got to go down on Madonna in Rome one night in some hotel. And ever since he's been depressed, 'cause life is shit from here on in. And all our friends just shake their heads and say too soon, too soon, too soon. He went down on Madonna too soon, too young, too young, too soon, too soon. And it ain't bragging if it's true. Yes, sir, yes, sir. It ain't bragging if it's true. Muhammad Ali said that back when he was Cassius Clay, before he fought too many fights and left his brain inside the ring. And sometimes I wish I was Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods. Sometimes I wish I was Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods. If certain girls don't look at you, it means that they like you a lot. If other girls don't look at you, it just means they're ignoring you. How can you know, how can you know which is which, who's doing what? I guess that you can ask them, which one are you, baby? Do you like me or are you ignoring me? Do you like me or are you ignoring me? Do you like me or are you ignoring me? And all you need to do that is one good pair of big balls. Balls as big as grapefruits, balls as big as pumpkins, balls as big as mine. But even though my balls are big, sometimes I wish they were bigger, even bigger. Big as the wheels on tractors, big as the golden arches, big as the Golden Gate Bridge, big as the state of Kansas, big as Mars and Jupiter, big as a swing of Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods, Tiger Woods.
Dan Byrne on
Witherspoon.
Radio for your spiritual side. A twisted approach to the left-hand path.
Broadcasting to you from the Tawa.
Widdershin's Tawa. So, where was it going? Oh, so I read the thing floating around Facebook. I think you could only tag like 40 dudes on the Facebook post. I think I stopped like 30 or something like that. It's just a lot of dudes. So, yeah, don't be offended if I didn't tag you, but it's floating around. And somebody's going to tag you in this thing. And it occurred to me, as I was thinking about talking about the male mysteries, is that the male mysteries that I know and the ones that I can talk about mostly are heterosexual. I don't know if these... If a lot of the things that I'm going to say correspond to the gay men's mysteries.
If they do not, then we could have a guest on next week to talk about other male mysteries.
I'd love to learn more. But, yeah, but like, you know, there's some things in the male mysteries just, you know, geared towards, like, procreation and shit, you know? I just don't know how that's going to apply. Maybe it will, maybe it won't. I don't know. But I was thinking, leading up to this show, I was a revolutionary anarchist, a eco-terrorist, as called by the FBI, the groups that I work for. I was busy defending the environment, workers' rights, and the rights of people that live on the street. One organization I was, they said I was a communist. Another organization I was involved in was I was an eco-terrorist. And the other, I was anarcho-socialist, they said. But, so, I was involved in all of these groups, and it's where I learned a lot about my I don't even know where I'm going. What am I talking about though? Wow, dead air. I had a point. I lost my point. You don't even know.
I'm just looking at your pretty mouth.
You're just looking at my pretty mouth. So I was involved in several political groups back in the day, and back then is when I learned some of my you know, my first male mysteries. Through the involvement of some of those groups, I was, first of all, I was polyamorous for over 20 years.
That's hot.
Well, it's not hot when you're married. Yeah.
Well,
back then it was hot. You thought that was hot?
I think it's hot still.
So for like 20 years, I was polyamorous before Marta. Marta's the one that fucked that all that.
What? I twisted your arm?
Yeah, but I like that. So somewhere in my travels, I had been married before all of this. I left a career in Long Beach, a marriage, and went on the road and ended up, you know, in the forest, fighting with a bunch of pagans to save trees, and that led to many other things. And somewhere in that, one of the women I hooked up with got pregnant at a very early age, and I had a daughter. I don't even think I was 30 yet, and I had a daughter, and that changed everything. I've known many men that don't have this, but I've known several men that had this. There's something in my genes that a switch got flipped. The second my child came out and was in this world, I was responsible for a world of shit. My job to keep that little thing safe, to do anything I could for this little life. I had not had an over-the-table job for 10 years. I was on the road serving those activist groups that I just laid out. Amongst other things, playing music to rouse the rabble with the two guys that we opened the show with. That was my job. I had no over-the-table job. I was on my way to get any job because I had a child due in 2 days, so my instinct was already kicking in. And I was on my way to 7-Eleven, and instead I ran into this other number, and it was 13. It was called 13 Real Magic, and it was going to be the first witch store to open in my town, and I ended up getting a job there. That was my first over-the-table job, and that was my motivation to get that job was this child. But I was a saboteur. I was a rabble-rouser. I destroyed many a machine. I maybe spiked a tree or a thousand. I never hurt a person. I never hurt an animal. I never hurt a thing. And when my daughter was a couple months old, I was pushing her stroller across the street, and somebody didn't stop their car fast enough and screeched their tires a little bit. I had already shoved the stroller out of harm's way and pushed myself into harm's way when, in my mind, I had leapt through this woman's car window and was reaching down her throat, pulling her innards out of her, throwing them into the streets, lighting them on fire, and dancing upon them. I was never a violent man before that. I had had a 3-year career as a police officer and managed to even handle that in a relatively non-violent fashion. I wrestled people. I never hit anybody. I never maced anybody. I never hit anybody with my billy club, but I wrestled some motherfuckers into handcuffs. God, I hope to hear that. Yeah. But it wasn't until I became a father that I became aware of a violent, animalistic piece of myself that exists for protecting their children. And women have it too. You know, you never, never fuck with a parent. You know, so you never fuck with a bear fucking that has cubs, male or female. You don't fuck with them. They're the most vicious fucking things you could ever run into. But this was my first, probably, introduction to the male mysteries. Most of my life, I can't count more than three gods I worshipped as back in my days of Wicca. There's Pan, Cornunos, and Lou. That's it. That's fucking it. The pantheon of goddesses I worship is off the fucking scale and encompasses probably every known portion of the fucking planet, and star goddesses beyond the fucking planet. I don't like men. I was not friends with men.
I don't like women.
See, exactly. In high school, all of my friends were women, and the men I interacted with tended to be their boyfriends wanting to kick my ass because they assumed that all of them were fucking me. And they weren't, because I was stupid. I probably could have been. Definitely could have been, in hindsight,
that's
but I was not. But there I am. Those are some male mysteries, too. So, I told you one thing. I don't want to give it all up. I gotta play some stuff. Play some. I guess we'll play songs for men. There we go. Widdershins.
I'm as cranky as a bitch. All I wanna do is spit. Nothing to eat after that feast. We're getting laid regular at least. And I don't wanna hurt you, so stay out of my way today. Every 28 days women bleed. Lest I get too much of your seed. My men gotta flush themselves out too. But it's always sexual when they do. You women, you just stick some pan inside. Men gotta practically fall in fucking love. Beautiful trees. Beautiful trees. Trees. As I've been around the bush, that's bad luck. I asked you in cause I wanna fuck. I asked you out cause I was hungry. And now I'm basically just tired. You don't have to leave. You can stay here. After all, this is still a love song. Beautiful trees. Beautiful trees. Beautiful trees.
Goddamn right.
Won't you tell everybody what the fuck you gotta say?
Fuck police coming straight from the underground. A young nigga got it bad cause I'm brown. And not the other color, so police think they have the authority to kill a minority. Fuck that shit cause I ain't the one for a punk motherfucker with a badge and a gun to be beaten on. And thrown in jail, we can go toe to toe in the middle of a sale. Fucking with me cause I'm a teenager with a little bit of gold and a pager. Searching my car, looking for the product, thinking every nigga is selling narcotics. You'd rather see me in the pen than me and Lorenzo rolling in a Benzo. Be the police out of shape, and when I finish, bring the yellow tape to tape off the scene of the slaughter. Still getting swole off bread and water. I don't know if they fags or what. Search a nigga down and grabbing his nuts. And on the other hand, without a gun, it can't get none. But don't let it be a black and a white one, cause they'll slam you down to the street top. Black police showing out for the white cop. Will swarm on any motherfucker in a blue uniform. Just cause I'm from the CPT, punk police are afraid of me, huh? A young nigga on the warpath, and when I finish, it's gonna be a bloodbath of cops dying in LA. Yo, Dre, I got something to say.
MC Ren, will you please give your testimony to the jury about this fucked up incident?
Fuck the police, and Ren said it with authority. Because the niggas on the street is a majority of gang. It's with whoever I'm stepping. And a motherfucking weapon is kept in a stash spot for the so-called law. Wishing Ren was a nigga that they never saw. Lights start flashing behind me. But they're scared of a nigga, so they mace me to blind me. But that shit don't work, I just laugh. Because it gives them a hint not to step in my path. But police, I'm saying, fuck you, punk. Read my rights and shit, it's all junk. Pulling out a silly club so you stand with a fake-ass badge and a gun in your hand. But take off the gun so you can see what's up. And we'll go at it, punk, and I'ma fuck you up. Think you think I'ma kick your ass. But drop your gat, and Red's gonna blast. I'm sneaky as fuck when it comes to crime. But I'ma smoke them now and not next time. Smoke any motherfucker that sweats me. Any asshole that threatens me. I'm a sniper with a hell of a scope. Taking out a cop or two that can't cope with me. The motherfucking villain that's mad. With potential to get bad as fuck. So I'ma turn it around. Put in my clip, yo, and this is the sound. Yeah, something like that. But it all depends on the size of the gap. Taking out a police would make my day. But a nigga like Ren don't give a fuck to say.
Fuck the police.
To the stand and tell the jury how you feel about this bullshit.
I'm tired of the motherfucking jacking. Sweating my gang while I'm chilling in the shack and shining the light in my face. And for what? Maybe it's because I kick so much, but I kick ass. Or maybe because I blast on a stupid ass nigga when I'm playing with the trigger of an Uzi or an AK. Because the police always got something stupid to say. They put out my picture with silence. Because my identity by itself causes violence. So E with the criminal behavior. Yeah, I'm a gangster, but still I got flavor. Without a gun and a badge, what do you got? A sucker in a uniform waiting to get shot by me or another nigga. And with a gat, it don't matter if he's smaller or bigger. And as y'all know, E's here the rule. Whenever I'm rolling, keep looking in the mirror. And it's on cue, yo, so I can hear a dumb motherfucker with a gun. And if I'm rolling off the 8, he'll be the one that I take out. And then get away while I'm driving off laughing. This is what I'll say. Fuck the police.
Jurious finds you guilty of being a redneck, white bread, chicken shit motherfucker.
Wait, that's a lie! That's a goddamn lie!
Get him out of here!
I want justice!
Get him the fuck out of my face!
I want justice!
Out right now!
Fuck you, you black motherfucker!
police.
Wiedersehen.
N.W.A.
I don't know what the hell we played before that. Dan Byrne? I think it was Dan Byrne. Oh, I don't know. You don't even remember.
Yeah. So all I want to do is spit.
That was Dan Byrne. Beautiful Trees.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm Wiedersehen's radio. Oh, where the fuck were we?
You were talking about your life.
Well, yeah. Well, I'm always talking about my life because, you know, I'm a bard. That's the way we tell stories. It's subtle. There's an art.
How you tell stories?
There's an art.
Don't mansplain to me.
No, I'm bard-splaining to you. There's an art to the form of bardism. And you and your ilk do not understand. I wish I could see the gestures that you're making. for I cannot describe them. Oh, Wiedersehen's radio. Oh, goodness. So, yeah, I think we touched a little bit on the violent streak. But both genders have a violent streak when it comes to protecting the children. This is why, you know, in our, you know, just recently we can see how vehement people get when, you know, they show pictures of immigrant children in cages crying and shit. That's why we get upset. It's instinctual. It's just wired into us. This is why, you know, they always show us suffering children when they want to drive us to war. 'Cause it works. It works on all of us. It's instinct. These are where the male mysteries come from. They're scientific, as you might imagine. They're perhaps boring, as you might imagine. They're logical. They have reason. They have data. Data. These male mysteries. And none of which that I'm speaking should even be a mystery. We know. We've seen the data. Maybe we don't understand where the data leads. Both male and female have this instinctual, violent tendency when it comes to protecting the young. It's wired into us. The young were vulnerable. We were scared little species once upon a time. Everything wanted to eat us. Everything wanted to eat us until we, like, learned to harness fire and scare them away. But protecting the young, that had to happen. Now, the difference was, I think, in the male mysteries, when there was another tribe that threatened to, you know, threatened our tribe, we'd kill the whole tribe. So I don't know. There are plenty of women throughout history that we could say did the same thing. But that kind of thing, that tends to be more male, more of a male mystery. And it's an instinct. And herein lies the rub with everything I'm going to say. Regarding the male mysteries, the huge portion of the male mysteries, at least from the hetero side that I know of, come from a pool of instincts wired into our animal nature, the majority of which do not need to exist anymore. Once upon a time, we were hunted, we were eaten, everything wanted to feast upon us. The survival of the human species was hanging on a thread. Those who created us wired into us certain things to keep the species alive, the majority of which don't need to exist anymore. There are still instincts. There are still things that we find ourselves motivated by. that don't need to exist. And, you know, being men, I'm sure no women are listening to this. It's just men. We're all here learning about our male mysteries.
I'm listening.
No, shut up. So, there's no women listening, of course. It's just men. We're learning about our things. But that's the thing we're going to find. We're going to find science. We're going to find, you know, technology. We're going to find things wired into our DNA because our species needed to survive. The human species right now, you know, unless Trump keeps power for too long, the human species is in no danger of departing.
Yeah.
I thought that look you gave me was going to ring more than yeah. But, yeah, until relatively recently, the human species was in no danger of not existing. And a lot of the things that are mysterious about men, we will find our instincts wired into us to keep the species alive. Instincts that no longer need to exist. Whoever built those into us didn't build a cutoff date or an off switch for these things. But, you know, I've talked about this. Marta knows, you know, of the things of which I speak. We see bees. When we see bees, well, we see males. This is kind of, you know, where the birds and the bees thing all goes, but some people kind of miss that. When we see bees out pollinating flowers, they're males. It's only one female, the queen. Males are drones. The queen is the queen. There's no other females in a beehive. And we see them going from flower to flower to flower, pollinating flower to flower to flower. Well, that's one of the things about men that tweaks women out the most, and nobody can seem to figure out. That's an instinct wired into us to procreate. And this is what I'm saying. It's like the majority of the male mysteries don't need to exist anymore. They're instincts wired into us to fuck everything we can possibly fuck to get it pregnant, to ensure the continuation of our bloodline, of our species. And furthermore, the younger flowers, well, they can produce more. So many times, you know, people trying to figure out, well, what is it about men and young women? It's a thing wired into us to help us procreate. The younger women are more fertile. Yeah.
This isn't about the young women, but I want to say there's a very abhorrent and disgusting movement right now. I think it's called stealthing, where so the guy is wearing a condom and they're having sex, and then he pulls off the condom during sex, and the whole point is to impregnate as many women as possible, and that's a movement now.
That's a thing?
Yep.
See, there's right there. The male mystery instincts gone wrong.
Yep.
We don't need any help. You know, unless, you know, Trump keeps going the way he's going. We don't need any help to survive. We are the dominant species. Look around. You know, we can just look at the skyline out from the tower right here. Clearly, we're in control. But we have these instincts wired into us that didn't have an expiration date, basically. But that kind of thing. The pollinating every fucking flower possible. The spreading your seed was to keep the gene pool spread out. So we didn't have too much inbreeding. And we've seen, we've learned as humans that too much inbreeding, you know, go to Alabama or Mississippi or something like that, you can see what too much inbreeding will fucking bring you. And the royals all learned that too. Much inbreeding.
They talk about King Tut and how his head was misshapen and he had a limp and he had all this biological disfigurations or whatever, and it's because of inbreeding, and he was kind of fucked up because of that.
Yeah,
and that's what they did. Like the pharaohs, like the brothers married the sisters, like over and over again to keep the bloodline pure, and they ended up with a lot of deformities and diseases and things like that. And the same thing, even with dogs. Like we wanted originally to get a purebred dog, and my friend who worked for the SPCA was like, "Get a mutt. Trust me." Get a mutt. They don't have that many health problems as a purebred does. So even with animals, it's the same thing.
Yeah, and that kind of thing. Somewhat male mysteries related, but you know, the keeping the bloodline intact thing. It's like there's a huge instinct for that with the males. And every society or every primitive culture on Earth that had a royalty did that same thing, and ultimately he came to that same conclusion, the inbreed. So we find ourselves all over the Earth ruled by these royal cultures everywhere that ended up being the lowest common denominator of the human species. No wonder we're fucked up. No wonder. I'm sorry, but we were being ruled by retards.
Yep.
There's a PC word for that. We were being ruled by the genetically mentally challenged for quite some time. No wonder we're messed up. But what was I on about before we went?
We're talking about like inbreeding and stuff, but I'm not sure how you got there.
Well, okay, well, mysteries. So instinctually, and again, I don't know how a lot of this stuff's going to apply to gay men, but heterosexual men, you know, I'm talking about those male mysteries. I cannot, you know, maybe we'll get a gay man on to discuss the gay men's male mystery. I mean, I'll probably get kicked out of the club anyways, even talking about the male mysteries. They'll come take my penis. But
no! That's mine.
But, you know, maybe somebody else can come talk about that. But I'm just talking from what I understand. See, I'm 52 now. I'm reaching the age where I find myself less and less ruled by the pussy.
What?
Except for Marta. I knew she was going to say that. We, as time goes on, we have more capacity to our brain. And we have more access to our brain. And figure out the things that motivated us in younger life, and recognize that those things are not necessarily our only motivations to this day. So, I know
that you fell in love with my brain before anything else.
Absolutely.
Or maybe after.
Absolutely. But I'm no longer, and hopefully it doesn't mean I'm going downhill, but you know, I don't feel the need to pollinate many flowers. So it changes, I guess, as you get older. But in that too, in the pollination of those flowers, there's this thing towards the younger flowers, to the extent where, you know, some guys go way too far and, you know, end up, you know, in prison.
Yeah.
You gotta wait till they're 18.
Don't be like them.
But there, I will not condone that, But I understand where that's coming from. It's this instinctual thing. As soon as women become fertile, you know, adolescence, that's when these other triggers are going off in the men. But the mystery is that the purpose for that was to procreate. And we're not there. I'm sure y'all don't want to procreate. Maybe some of you out there want to procreate when you're thinking about getting laid. But that's not the purpose. But a lot of the things that trip people out about what men do are based on these fucking instincts to keep our species alive that have no more reason to exist. We're still driven by them. But men understand science. And special women like Marta, they understand science too.
I understand science too.
But science helps it make sense. The male mind is this linear, straight line kind of mentality. And it somehow, when it's scientific, it helps us understand it. We have these instincts wired into us that didn't have an off switch or didn't have an expiration date. And we're just not there anymore. We don't need to spread our seed all over the place to continue the human population. We don't need to seek out the most youngest and most fertile of the females in our tribe to procreate with, because most of us are just trying to get fucked and not pregnant. Darian,
that's what was always
one of the mysteries. Wittershits.
Could not reach the shore. We're all just dancers, all the devil's dance floor. Well, swing a little more, a little more, and then there we go. Swing a little more, a little more next to me. Swing a little more, a little more, and then there we go. Swing a little more on the devil's dance floor. Pressed against her face, I could feel her insecurity. Might have been a drunk, and her father was obscurity. Nothing ever came from a life that was a simple one. Pull yourself together, girl. Was a furry one. Her legs ran all the way up to heaven and past Avalon. Tell me something, girl, what it is you have in store. She said, come with me now, I'm the devil's dance floor. Well, swing a little more. We'll be right back.
video games, train the kids for war. Only she can have fashion stores. Life orders done their job. Prisons filled while the rich still love.
Assassination politics. Violence rules within our nation's midst. Well, ignorance is their power too. Lousy, but the blind don't know. You when you're on your own. The silence of conspiracy. Slaughter on it all to all apathy. You gotta wake up from your sleep. Cause we can hear it at 6 feet deep.
Bad Religion, of course, on Wittershins Radio. And it comes time for me to remind you people about the package.
Oh, baby, the package. Tell them about the package.
Here at Spreaker, you need to follow the shows that you like. We're almost up there. We're like 98 followers right now. We need to get up to 100. Then we can do iHeartRadio too.
Yeah,
got it up there. Yeah, iHeartRadio. But you got to follow. We are on every Tuesday, 5 p.m. Pacific time. And any fucking time we want. When we take a day off, we pop up whenever the hell we want. If there's something going on in the world, we pop up whenever the hell we want. Our friends on Spreaker, Candelo's Corner, Ambrosine Laguerre, even Beverly Smith, they can pop up whenever they want, whenever there's something going on. Candelo's Corner has been doing the it's 12 o'clock somewhere show, like 4 days a week at least. And you won't know when that show's happening unless you follow. You can follow very easily by clicking, use my Facebook, unless you don't have a Facebook. Who the fuck are you if you don't have a Facebook? You click on use my Facebook account. You can have an account on Spreaker in seconds, mere seconds. Be in the chat room, on the show, when there's stuff going on. You can receive push notifications on the shows that are going on. Oh, my God. You need to follow. Follow. You can find us at thesacredgrovestore.com, youtube.com/freakphil1309. That's FREAKPHIL, and the number's 1309. And Wittershins. Wittershinsradio@gmail.com. You can send us messages. And we'll be sure to check those messages really soon.
We promise.
To check
them. Oh, God.
Party foul. I got to clean that up.
Okay. But I'm not going to have beer on my floor.
I know. I said I got to clean up. I spilled. I'm trying to keep up on the foam right now. Wittershins.
I'm not talking anymore.
All right. I'm going to clean the floor while I'm talking to you people. So, the Let Them Eat War is kind of the part of the thing that I was going to talk about next. The war thing. Now, many will not recognize, but there are several prominent figures, female figures, in war over the centuries. But it tends to be a thing that men are blamed for.
Oh,
we're blamed. We're blamed for war. And it's not always been an entirely male thing, but it tends to be something that we're more involved in than most people. And that again, the survival of the tribe, the survival of the species, the survival of the young, that's again a thing that's programmed into us that maybe doesn't need to exist these days, or maybe needs to exist less.
You
just keep looking at me. But maybe it needs to exist less. It's less required that we kill off the neighboring tribe to survive than it once was. And that's the thing that's programmed into us, why it's so easy for our governments to encourage the men to join the military. The protecting the tribe, that's the instinct that they're working off of. But the tribe doesn't need much protection anymore. You know, the majority of the male mysteries are instincts that don't need to exist anymore. And we're driven by them. And that's something, you know, we as men, we need to figure that out. We need to figure out where that's appropriate, where that's not appropriate. What does it take for our species to survive anymore? Not a whole lot. Most of our instincts don't need to be there anymore. And that's the thing for us men, scientifically, to look at. And we have things programmed into our DNA that don't need to exist anymore. That's the bottom line. What do you got to say?
Yes.
You agree?
I concur.
Well, you're a woman, so who cares? If you could have seen that look she gave me.
the little hand is on the two. The big hand is pointing at you. Now, what time is that? My clock glows in the dark. What does yours do? Marbles in my hand. I want to go down to the store. I want to go where God knows best. I want to go to Sunday school. Jesus loves me. Yes, I know. I mean it. The little hand is on the two. The big hand is pointing at you. Now, what time is that? You tell me. Sometimes I like to wind up my clock so the hands will point in different special ways. Sometimes I like to wind up my clock so the hands will point in different special ways. Everybody knows that a good fucking Christian prays!
Crucifix.
Crucifix.
Ghetto bird. Ghetto bird. Got the ghetto bird flying by. Woo! So, where were we?
We're talking about male mysteries. Of which I know nothing.
We are not that mysterious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I pretty much know what y'all are up to.
Yeah.
Most of the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Apparently.
Well, I think I prefaced it when I went into the show. It's like, the male mysteries are instincts that we no longer need to have. The majority of them. I don't know what else to say about that.
Yeah, I mean, most men who I've been with were definitely not trying to impregnate me.
Really?
Yeah. Except for you.
But they were operating off the instincts.
Yes.
It's like, yes. It's like,
well, that's my point, is that you don't need it any longer.
I know. And a lot of the attraction between male and female, subconsciously, is because those two people can make babies.
I make babies.
Alright. What do we all say about that? I want to rock out.
Okay, let's rock out.
Going to rock out?
Let's rock out.
We're going to rock out. On Wittershins.
Absinthe is the aphrodisiac of the self. The green fairy who lives in the absinthe wants your soul.
Come taste this lunacy. Be blinded by the green fairy. Creeping out of your glass into your mind, then you can really see. I can take all of your fears, transform the way you feel. Welcome to the spirit world where all your dreams are real. If you want to take a chance, seduction's in a glass, taking you to another place. Round and round and around, flowing by. As the evening starts to crawl like shadows on the walls, I'm dancing and inviting you to come and taste it all.
On and on and on for eternity. Well, I know I miss more than hit. With a face that was launched to sink. And I seldom feel the bright relief. It's been the worst day since yesterday. If there's one thing I have said, is that the dreams I once had now lay in bed. As the four winds blow my wits through the door, it's been the worst day since yesterday. Falling down to you, sweet ground, where the flowers they bloom, well, it's there I'll be found. Hurry back to me, my wild calling. It's been the worst day. Looking down through a tide of no return is a field where the crops no longer grow. Parched is the land, strangled and be damned. Therefore the grace of God go away. Down beside where the riverbed sleeps is a man not knowing what he should feel. Mocked by the wave that beats the water's edge. Therefore the grace of God. Therefore the grace of God. Therefore the grace of God go away. If I ever hurt another like thee again, I would drown myself beneath your name. Lost was the child we all once did hide. Therefore the grace of God. Therefore the grace of God. Therefore the grace of God. away. I spend it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass, good night and joy be with you. Oh, all the comrades that e'er I had are sorry for my going away, and all the sweethearts that e'er I had would wish me one more day to stay. But since it falls unto my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and I'll softly call, good night and joy be with you.
God bless.
Oh,
darkness that I encounter everywhere I turn. I've seen it all along in books and magazines, like a drink before dying, like a pornographic scene. There's a far behind the window, there's an ugly laughing man, like a hummingbird in silence, like the blood on my door. It's a turbines in darkness, like the blood on my door.